Good morning. I look like the sun today. Well, I mean, the sun's yellow. Is it yellow or is it orange? I don't know. I guess it's yellow. Whatever. I feel bright and cheery. Good morning. This is so fantastic. They let you see the faces of the people. Look at all these cute faces. Look at all you pretties. How is everybody? Thanks for popping on. You know, I do my best. It is very important to me to be punctual. When corporate does their Facebook Lives, and I know they have a lot of moving parts and they have a lot going on, okay? But I am sorry. When you say you're going to do something at 2:30 Pacific Standard Time or what Pacific Daylight Time, I need it to go at 2:30, because when it's 2:33 or 2:34, I start to get a little anxiety. And I understand that's my issue. It's something that I have to work on. I have to learn to lighten up a little bit. Maybe I'm a little too rigid. Maybe I'm just a little too, you know. Well, Miss Lee, good morning. Good morning. I hope you're feeling better. Hi, guy. Oh, Shari Day, you're so funny, Paula. Thank you so much. Hello. Yeah, maybe I'm a little too rigid when it comes to that. You see, I grew up with a mother who always had me to my practices and games 30 minutes early. Like, literally, we would get to the game before the refs. Like, we would be there before the grounds crew. So I'm not that bad, but I'm punctual, and some of my friends tease me because even when I try to be late, even when I try to be the cool girl that like shows up a little bit late, I can't. Even when I'm like, oh no, for sure, I'm going to be like 10 minutes late. I'm going to show up all easy breezy. No, something always happens and I get there right on the dot, right on the dot. So, you know what? And I get stressed when I'm late. So anyway, that's why I'm here. Yes. Oh, Anya. Hi, Anya. Oh, thanks, love. No, I'm here every Friday, Facebook Live. Now, listen, since you're all my friends, I'm just going to tell you kind of what's going through my head right now is, I'm thinking of possibly doing a business page. And starting to do my lives from a business page versus my personal wall. I don't know. You know, it's one of those things with Facebook where we never know what is the best way, what is the best thing. But I kind of think, you know, because I started my business page when I first started with the company, but I don't really work that page. And I don't want that page to be an example to you of what to do, because my focus is in other areas, not so much on my business page. And so I don't feel like I'm the best example. And so I'm thinking of revamping. So anyways, I don't know why I'm sharing that. I'm just sharing that with you just to let you know. We're all a work in progress and we will never be done. I don't know why I'm wearing this sweatshirt. It's a little bit warm already and I gotta crank up the air. Yeah, so I'm thinking about doing that. So if I do that, I will let everybody know and I will shoo everybody over so that I'm doing my lives. Because then I think I might end up doing more lives, more often, maybe shorter amounts of time. Okay? All right. Do you like that, Tess Benson? Do you like it? Okay. All right. Let's talk sponsoring. Now, again, you know me, I'm all about training. I love to train. I love to share what I know. I love to brainstorm. I love all that. As part of that training, I want you to understand, and it's why I'm telling you about the business page idea and all of that stuff, because I just want you all to understand that it's the brain keeping going. It's the same for everybody. Nobody has the answers. Nobody knows, like, what is a surefire way for something to go? Is it going to work? Is it not going to work? I don't know. We're going to try it. We're going to see how it goes. We're going to, you know, So when I talk about sponsoring, I will tell you that it goes through my head that I'm thinking, all right, what am I going to say that I haven't said 150,000 times already? Because I want to provide something new. I want to provide something fresh. So there's some pressure there on me, on any of your leaders who you come to and you ask, help me with sponsoring. It's like, okay, because the good news is it's simple. It's not easy. It's simple. That's the good news. The bad news is because it's simple, it's hard to find a lot of fresh new things, okay? And I am going to bet that 95% of you, when I talk about this sponsoring, you're going to go, yeah, I knew that. Yeah, I knew that. I knew that. Because you knew, but now you got to do. You see, you knew, but now you got to do. So I'm just prefacing by that, because saying that, because, you know, I don't know that we're going to have any big revelations, but we're just going to review sponsoring, because you need to learn three things in any business, really in any business. It doesn't matter if you're in direct sales or not. Okay. You need three things. You need to know how to sell. Okay. You need to know how to build a team, which is sponsoring. So selling, sponsoring, and you need to know how to lead. Okay? We'll get into leadership on another day, because that's a whole other Oprah. Selling. Some of you have challenges with selling. I'm going to just say that's one place that you need to start. Okay? You need to learn how to sell. How do you learn how to sell? You watch people who are good at selling. You read books about selling. You get Audible in your ears, Audible books, while you're folding laundry, while you're putting your makeup on in the morning. That's the perfect time. When people say to me, I don't have time to read. Yeah, you do. You have time for someone to read to you while you're putting your makeup on in the morning. You listen to that. While you're driving in your car, you listen to it, because you can crank through at the bare minimum one book a month, 12 books a year. It'll change you as a human, okay? It will change you as a human. I feel like I'm fuzzy. Okay. So, three things you need. Sell, sponsor, lead, okay? Need to know how to sell. Because think about it. When you are sponsoring, what are you doing? You're selling the business opportunity. So you need that basis of knowing how to sell. Now, that being said, I feel like sponsoring for me is a much softer sell than even selling mascara or whatever it is that you sell. Okay? It's for me, it is a softer sell. Okay, let me give you a story. I feel like stories help you understand. Once upon a time, I used to work for Robinson's department store. Rob May, Robinson's May Company, the whole thing, right? And I worked in the cosmetics department, and we had to open five credit cards a week, okay? So that's why when you go shopping and someone says, you know, that store's not around anymore, but like Macy's lady says, would you like to put this on your Macy's charge? Because she's waiting for you to say, oh, I don't have a Macy's charge. And then she said, would you like a Macy's charge? Oh my God, you could save like $4 today if you open up a Macy's charge. Oh my God, right? And you're going, no, I don't want that, right? Now, when I tell her that I don't want a Macy's card, is it because I think that she's an idiot? No. Even though I guess I did just make fun of her, and I do apologize. I was just doing it for effect. But is it because I wish that she was never born? No. I respect her for doing her job, right? But what she does not know is that I get Nordstrom points, and Nordstrom sends me gift cards. So that trumps all. Okay? You, okay, I'm not taking your Macy's card, because Nordstrom's going to send me a gift card if I put it on my Nordstrom card, so I'm putting it on my Nordstrom card. Okay. Five instant credit. So I had to open five of those. So I was that girl. I hated that. I hated asking people if they wanted to open up a credit card because they would most often say no. Okay. So, but here's what would happen if I wouldn't ask every single person at the end of the month, if I hadn't met my quota, guess what? They would make me go stand at the entrance to the store with a stack of little like credit pamphlets and ask every person who walked into the store. You know, when you say, "Hi, how are you? Would you like to open up a credit card?" They wouldn't even look at me. They wouldn't even look at me. It's very embarrassing. But it built character. It built character. Because I got to where I didn't care. But that's what would happen. If I didn't do the little baby steps every single time. So what did that teach me? It taught me that even if I thought to myself, ugh, I don't feel like asking this person. I don't feel like saying anything today. I'm feeling lazy today. I'm feeling tired today. I'm feeling frumpy, grumpy. I don't know what today. Oh, you better ask every single person. You better make it a habit of asking every single person or your booty's going to end up at the front door. Now, here's what you got to understand. I worked on commission. So if I'm spending 3 or 4 hours at the front door, I am losing hundreds and hundreds of dollars that I could not afford to lose. Okay? So, you need to shift your mind when it comes to sponsoring. Sponsoring is the little tiny nuggets, and it's the little tiny breadcrumbs. It's the little seeds that you plant every single day. Every single day. It is the repetitive habits that you need to find within your life. So it brings me to flying fish. Not fly fishing. Someone said fly fishing. No, we're not fly fishing. We're not fishing with flies. I'm a bit of a fisher person, I will tell you. I was raised fishing. My dad used to take me out on the lake. And why we would have to get up at 4 a.m, I still am not completely sure. I know the fish like the morning hours. I do not. Sidebar, I threw up almost every time because it's just too early in the morning and he would give me hot chocolate. Blech. Ugh, God, it's not good. God bless him for taking me because I wouldn't be taking my kids. So we would go fishing. Now, I'm talking flying fish, fish that fly through the air. You know these things? You know these? They're like unicorns, but they exist, these flying fish. So let's just say that you and I are going to go out on a boat. We each got our own boat. Everybody's got their own boat, and we're going out on Lake Sponsorilotopus, okay? And we're cruising out on Lake Sponsorilotopus, and whoever catches the most fish has the biggest team, right? I don't know, people. I'm pulling this out of my hoo-ha, but I'm just saying. Follow me here. Follow me here. I have a point. There's all these fish in there, and every fish represents a person on your team. Okay? Now, here's what a lot of people do. They get out in the middle of that lake, and they sit in their boat, and they cry. And they cry. I can't sponsor. I can't catch fish. I don't know how to catch fish. There's no fish. They're expecting the flying fish to just fly into their freaking boat. Flying fish is not going to fly into your freaking boat, okay? It's not going to fly into your boat. You got to get a pole. You got to put some bait on it. That bait is value, providing value, providing a reason for them to join. That bait could just be you simply asking. It could just be you asking. I'm telling you, you're not sponsoring because you're not opening up your mouth enough. You're not talking about it. You're not asking for it because you think that if you ask and they say no, that they hate you. That it means that you are worthless. That it means that what you're doing is dumb. No. you're just getting more. If they say no to you, it's just because for all you know, they got a Nordstrom card and they're getting gift cards, right? And if you just tuned in right now, you have no idea what I'm talking about. You're going to have to watch it from the beginning. But it all ties together. If somebody was taking notes on this seriously and then someone came along and left Nordstrom card, flying fish in the boat, sponsor Alatapus Lake. Mm-hmm. So you're in the boat, you're crying because the fish won't get into your boat. So then you look over and you see Black Status presenter Jess Parizik, who is a world-class fisherwoman person. Oh no. If you follow her on Facebook, like, she is legit. She's got a, I don't know what kind of fish, a walleye, something, a big fish on tattoo. She's over there. Guess what Jess is doing? Jess has like 12 poles in the water. Jess has hired people to help her hold the poles, and she is dropping lines in the water like a boss. Zzz, zzz, right? You're not going to expect to fill your boat with fish if you are not fishing. If you are not putting a line in the water to get the fish. When someone, and I'm not going to mention any names, you know who you are if you're watching me, but thank you for the inspiration. She knew she was my inspiration yesterday for this Friday Facebook Live because she said, Shari, I need some help sponsoring. And I'm like, fine, awesome, okay. So, how many times have you asked in the last week, asked people to join your team? I'm going to get to that in a minute too. I don't want you just saying, hey, join my team. I mean, you can, but there's other ways to do it. I think that a lot of people don't ask because they don't want to say that phrase, right? So I said, how many people have you asked, or how many times have you put it out on your Facebook wall in the last week? And she's like, yeah, good point. Thanks. Right? I mean, I kind of knew the answer to that. If you're not sponsoring, it's because you're not asking often enough. I don't want to end up standing at the entrance to that store having to hand out instant credit applications. Okay? You don't want to end up not having enough qualified presenters on your team for you to hit your status. Okay? That's the equivalent. You don't want to end up at the end of the month freaking the freak out, right? So what do? You have to do the baby steps every single day. So what does that look like? Let's talk about what that looks like. Number one, okay? And I'm talking also to those of you who've been in the business, but those of you who are brand spanking new. You have got to be open. Your whole, like, personality, energy, whatever, has to be open. You have got to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. You cannot be like this. If you're just quiet, or you've got RBF, look it up if you don't know. If you've got RBF, you know, and you're just, who is going to want to work with you? Nobody's going to want to work with you. If you're open, if you're confident, fake it till you make it, and you're confident about your business, people say, hey, you know what? That might be fun. That might be fun to do that with her. And you know, the thing is, you know, you can be confident and not know what you're doing. Do you know that? Do you know that? Because here's what I know. I don't care what you throw at me. Underwater basket weaving. Hey, guess what? I got an underwater basket weaving team. Who's going to do it with me? I've never done it before, but I'm going to find out how. Do you trust me? You do. You trust me, because guess what? I'm going to find out how. I don't care what it is. I don't care if auto mechanic something. If I want to do auto mechanic, I am going to learn how to do that, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Do you know, at one point I even thought about having like a place like for women, like a Jiffy Lube for women kind of a thing. Do you know what I'm saying? Like to help women or to teach them. I don't know. It was something. I've always been looking for ideas for businesses, okay? So, thank God for this, because this was easy peasy. This was like, I didn't even have to do anything but sign up, and here it all was for me. But you have to be open. You have to be approachable. Okay? That's step number one. Step number two, you have to keep your eyes open. You have to be on the lookout for 5 seeds every single day. 5 seeds to plant every single day. I plant a lot of seeds in line at Starbucks. Yes, I do. You have to understand, as a sidebar here, you have to understand that most people that you talk to about the business are not going to join your business. It's expectations that also get you into trouble. You think, well, I asked somebody, and then they said no. So, I suck. No. No. Okay? Most people are going to say no. Most are going to say no. If it's hard on your ego, if you are a delicate flower, give them an out. Give them an out. Summer Ruger, she's a Black Status presenter. Love what she does with sponsoring. She sponsors like a boss. What does she do? She reaches out to people and she says, hey, why aren't you doing this with me yet? That's it. That's how she sponsors. That's it. It's not this big. You're not asking them to marry you. You're not even, you know, you're barely asking them out on a coffee date, okay? You're not asking them to marry you. This is not, you have got to not worry about rejection. You have to say the words. You have to put it out there. But give them an out. Why aren't you doing this with me yet? Is that pushy? Is that rude? Not at all. Because what are they going to say? Oh, girl, you're crazy. I can't do that business. Well, why not? You're getting a conversation going. Or they're going to say, hell no, I am not doing that. Hey, you know what? It's not a no for forever. It's a no for now. They say that now. I have a lady that just joined my team. We have been friends for, I don't know, 20 years. She was around when I started this business. She saw my business take off. She still said no, 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 no. And then she found herself in a life situation where she was like, okay, I need to do this. Okay, I need to help my family. I need to... The timing was just right. But I had planted seeds for almost 4 years. For almost 4 years. And that's why you have to plant at least 5 seeds a day. It could be something as simple as being in line at Starbucks and you hear somebody. I don't know about you. Do you chat with people in line at Starbucks when you get a chance? If somebody's talking to you, but in front of you, someone's talking to you behind you, whatever. Get in a habit of being open and chatting with people. It's a good skill to have anyway. But if I hear somebody talking about how expensive it is to buy a cup of coffee, oh, my kids are coming home from college. Oh, my gosh, I can't believe. Oh, my son's graduating from high school. He's starting college next year. Oh, it's so expensive. Oh, my God. Oh, blah, blah, blah. Oh, sports. Oh, we can't take a vacation this year. Da, 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 da. What do I say? Hi. Yeah, that was me. Oh, my God. That was me. That is so stressful. I'm being legit. I'm talking to her as a person. Okay, I'm not talking to her as a salesy person. I'm talking to her as a person because it is legit. What if that was me and somebody didn't tell me about this opportunity to make extra money? Okay? It's not going to be for everybody. Know that going in. Take that pressure off of yourself. It's not going to be for everybody. But you don't know. It might be for her. It might be for her friend. You don't know that God placed you in that exact moment because she needed to hear about it, because she's going to have lunch with somebody next week who's going to need some extra money, who's going to end up being, you know, going through a divorce, single mom, you know, whatever, losing their home. You don't know. When those moments hit and when you get that little inkling, oh, I should tell her about the business. Oh, I'm scared. And then you get the little devil on the shoulder. Oh, I'm scared. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. And I'm going to sound stupid and I'm going to word vomit all over. I'm going to say too much and then I'm going to scare blah, 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 blah. Number one, it's not about you. Little angel over here is saying, shh, it's not about you. Here's what you say. You say,
Oh my God, I can feel that because I have been there. Let me just tell you something right now, and this is going to sound crazy. And you hand her your card and you say, listen, this is going to sound crazy, but you need to go to this website. And if this speaks to you at all, or you have questions, please call me, because I am not kidding you. This changed my life. This changed my life. And I work from my phone. And it is so simple. And I show women how to do it every day. Oh, thank you so much. Wasn't that nice of me? Was that not nice of me? You can be nice too. That's how you have to think of it. But you know what? I planted a seed. I feel like if I go through my day and I follow my intuition and I go where I feel like my heart is being led, okay? And whatever religious affiliation you have or whatever guidance system that you have, hey, we all get guidance and it all comes in different forms, okay? But when I feel like baby Jesus is speaking to me and telling me, you need to go over here, you need to talk to this person, you need to, you know, chat this one up, you need to hand a card to this one. Sometimes I've been getting my nails done, and don't you know I plant a seed every time I get my nails done, but I've been chatting to the lady next to me and telling her she's getting her nails done. And we just get on the subject. I don't have this script or this, don't have a script. You need to practice what you're going to say. Keep it short and simple. Practice what you want to say. Why aren't you doing this with me yet? Do you know how many friends that I had that I would say, okay, seriously, why aren't you doing this with me yet? And I'd be like, oh God, oh, you're so crazy. Oh, da, da, da. Right? It's fine. I'm like, all right, call me when you, timing may not be right for you right now. Call me when you need me. You know where to find me. I'm the girl with the big lashes. Mm-hmm. And eventually they come around. Or they don't. Or they say, hey, Shari, my cousin just got laid off. She wants to talk to you because I was telling her about you. Or whatever. Okay? But yeah, sometimes I'm chatting up the lady getting her nails done next to me. And we start chatting. And who knows? At some point, there's a little opening of me talking about, I don't know, going to convention, or I started working a business so that I could afford a mani-pedi once a month. Now I get them twice a month because I'm fancy. You know, you never know. But those little tiny seeds, if you are keeping your eyes peeled, I promise you, it is a muscle, okay? You keep your eyes peeled and follow your intuition and follow your guidance, and you're going to start seeing more opportunities. When you open yourself up and you open your eyes and start looking for it, you're going to find it. Think about all of the places you regularly go in your day that you just keep to yourself and you don't talk to people. Think about when you go to Target. Do you see the same checkers there very often? Do you get in line with the same checker every time? Maybe you should. Maybe so you get to know them. My goal is always to get to be on a first name basis with people where I go throughout my life, when my business, when I'm going to the post office, when I'm going to Starbucks, when I'm going to Panda Express. Sorry, I love Panda Express and I eat there often. When I go to Target, you have to pretend you're running for mayor. You want to get to know all the people in your area. The same goes for online. So, because I can hear you out there, I live in a little tiny town. Well, listen, I live in a little tiny town too. Never stop me. This is an online business. You don't live in my town, and yet you see me through the magic of this creature that I'm holding. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't even know where I live. You don't even know where I'm sitting right now. And you can see me and you can hear me. So, maybe that means you need to find more groups of people on Facebook that you connect with. And I mean genuinely connect with. You genuinely, people can smell BS and they can smell a rat. You need to find people who enjoy doing what you do, who enjoy skiing, who have twins, who have triplets, who have a child with special needs, who have a love of cats. I see a kitty over there. Who loves cats? Who loves, I don't know what, okay? Whatever, roller skating, something. There's something that you love to do. And if you can't think of something that you love to do, you need to find things that you love to do, because this is the only life you have and you need to be enjoying your life, okay? You need to be enjoying your life. So that's part of it. Get involved in these groups and make friends. You're not going to come right out of the gate and say, hey, join my team. Hey, right. And you're not joining these groups to be sleazy. You're joining these groups so that you can, number one, enrich your own life. You can make friends with people. And if they ask what you do, then you tell them what you do. They're going to end up seeing what you do. And again, it may not be for them, but it may be for someone that they know. But the bottom line is, anyone who knows you never has to pay for makeup again. Do you realize that? Anyone who knows you never has to pay for makeup again, because they can constantly be hosting online parties. Yeah. You're a good friend to have. So take the pressure off of yourself of thinking that to sponsor, I have to go knocking door to door and I have to go cold calling to get people to join my team. You have to open your mouth. You have to talk about it. You have to post on Facebook and show your lifestyle and show yourself having fun, and then say the words, okay, people, why aren't you doing this with me yet? Who's going to do this with me? Who wants to be here? Who wants to, you know? You need to ask, because I guarantee you, you haven't been asking enough. And one of the biggest challenges that I hear people say is they run out of people. So I'm telling you right now, because I just saw a comment go up that they run out of people. You need to find interests. You need to make a bigger life for yourself. You need to get out of your car and go sit in the bleachers at baseball practice with the other moms. You need to chat up the other moms. Okay, let me give you an example. I was at baseball practice 2 weeks ago, feeling stressed because I had a million things and we just got there at the last minute. Okay, right in time, but right at the last minute. I was feeling really stressed. Now, my husband is retired and we have 2 kids. Okay, it's manageable. I was just being a whiny butt. And this young girl comes walking over and sits down in the stands. And she has a toddler. And she has a son out there playing with my son. And we got to chatting. Oh, because I was supposed to bring snack, but then they switched it. So she was going to bring snack and then I was going to bring snack the next week. And she said, oh, I'm so sorry. She goes, I didn't mean to like take your snack day or move your snack day or whatever. She goes, I just felt bad. I haven't brought snack yet this year and the season's almost over. So I said, oh, I said, if please don't worry about that. It is not a problem. It is not a problem. She goes, yeah. She goes, so many times I'm getting here late or I have to leave early because I have to go to work. And I said, oh, what do you do? She goes, oh, I work at In-N-Out. I'm like, oh my God, I love In-N-Out. So we get to talking. She's a single mom. She's 25 years old. She's got a 6-year-old boy and a 3-year-old boy. And she was telling me where she lived in town. Low income housing, right? But beautiful, like apartments. She goes, yeah, you know, I was lucky enough. This girl's attitude, let me tell you something. She was not complaining. She goes, I was so lucky to be able to get into that place. And she goes, I used to work part-time at In-N-Out before I had my kids. And then I took some time off because I had to take care of them. And now I'm back and I'm working full-time and it's great, but I have to work nights so that I can be around for the kids during the day and my parents help me out and whatever. And she was just living her life and appreciative of everything she had, and I'm sitting there staring at her, and I want to cry because I know how hard that must be for her. And you know what I said? I said, okay. I can't even with this. I dug in my purse and I got out a card. And I flat out said to her, you listen to me right now, sister. You are working really hard. Way too hard. For not enough money. You deserve to be with those boys and make more money. And I'm happy to help you and show you how to do it. But you got to go to this website and check it out. I go, I don't usually come like right out guns blazing like that. But seriously, you are amazing. Like, you are incredible. And your attitude, I literally can't even right now. I work from my phone. I'm home with my kids. Like, this could be a whole new life for you. And she was like, wow, oh my gosh, that's amazing. Right? So she took my card. She checked it out. The next time I saw her, she was like, okay, I think I need to try that mascara because that looks amazing. Just between you and me, I cannot let her buy a mascara. I gave her a mascara. She has not signed up yet, but I did my job. Something spoke to my heart and said, you get in there and you let this girl know that this is available for her. It is not my responsibility for her to join, but I did my work. And if you do your work, if you follow your intuition and you plant those 5 seeds every single day and then let go of the rest of it, you did your job. Girlfriend, you did your job. You plant those seeds 5 a day, letting people know what is available if it speaks to them. And then you let go of the results. And I promise you, you will never have to worry about sponsoring again. It's just going to flow to you. It's going to flow to you. But you got to get out of your own way. You have to get out of your own way. You have to change your mindset. You have to stop beating the drum of what you don't want. And by that I mean, you beat the drum of, I can't sponsor, 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 I can't sponsor. Nobody joins my team. Nobody joins my team. Nobody joins my team. Nobody joins my team. I can't sponsor. Yeah, that's the law of attraction. You're drawing that to you through the beating of that drum. You need to say, I am open to following the guidance. I am open to planting seeds every day. Every single day I look for 5 seeds to plant. Every single day I look for 5 seeds to plant. Doesn't that even feel better? Every single day I look for 5 seeds to plant. Right? Do you know they're planting pumpkins here coming up pretty soon? Why are they planting pumpkins? Are they planting pumpkins because they want a pumpkin next month? When do we get pumpkins? Not till October. Okay? You have to plant your seeds now. Because you don't know, it could take 6 months, it could take a year, it could take 3 years. But if you're planting 5 seeds a day, that's a lot of seeds. That's a lot of seeds. And that's what's going to grow your business. It's the little tiny steps every single day. Get those fishing lines in the water. You have to get them in the water if you want to catch fish. Remember, those fish are not going to fly into your boat. Okay, I love you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you next Friday. Keep the comments coming and the questions, and I'll be happy to answer. Okay, love you guys. Thanks. Bye.